In this lesson, we are going to be looking at solving equations, both exponential and logarithmic. One thing I wanted to kind of reiterate, so let's look at this real fast. Let's remember something about logarithms. If we have logarithm base 2 of 1 over 8, and we're trying to evaluate that, that means we're trying to figure out what it equals. So let's remember what logarithms mean. The answer to the logarithm is the exponent. So we're looking at 2 to what power gives you 1 over 8? Well, it's got to be a negative number if I'm going to have a fraction, because 2 cubed, reminder, 2 cubed would be 8, so 2 to the negative 3 would be 1 over 8. All right, another review, ln of e to the 7. Now remember what ln stands for. Ln really means log base e of e to the 7th. So if you're thinking about it again like this, e to what power gives me e to the 7th? Well, it's got to be 7. Another way to think about it is matching bases. Ln or log base e is the inverse of e to the x, so they undo each other, and you just get 7 back. Next one, log base 3 of negative 9. So on this one, again, we're trying to think 3 to what power would give me negative 9? Well, 3 squared is 9. 3 to the negative 2 is 1 over 9. There is no way to get that negative number. Another way to remember is that you cannot have a negative argument. If you remember our graph, the graph of a logarithm didn't have anything on the negative side for x's. So your input cannot be negative. This does not exist. Same thing for the log of 0. Remember, then there's nothing there. That means 10. 10 to what power gives me 0? There's no way to get there. So that does not exist either. Oops. So we can never have our argument 0 or negative. Now, when we're solving equations, we want to be careful for this. Because remember, what were extraneous solutions? We looked at those in the past. An extraneous solution, you get there using correct algebra. So you did the problem right, but you get a math error. When you check your answer. So think of some things that would give you a math error. Things that would give you a math error. Dividing by 0. Square root of a negative. So let's look at dividing by 0. That's a math error. Square root of a negative. Also, the logarithm of a negative. Those are all errors. Those are all bad things. So we want to make sure we always check our answer and look for an extraneous solution, because all of those are no goods. All right. Now, I want to go through some examples, and there's several situations that you're going to run into when you're solving equations. One of those situations is what I call matching bases. So in the matching bases situation, we want to make sure, well, matching bases, that our bases match. So let's look at a couple of examples here. 81 to the 3 minus x equals 1 over 3 to the 5x minus 6. Okay. So I said matching bases, but 81 and 1/3, those don't match. I'm just being crazy, right? Well, how about we try to make them match? So how can I rewrite 81 to have a base of 3? Well, that would just be 3 to the 4th, because 3 squared is 9. And all of that's going to be to the 3 minus x. How can I rewrite 1/3 as 3 to some power? Well, remember, that would have to be a negative exponent. That would be a negative 1. Now, power to another power. The shortcut we always joke about is 2 in the sky. We're going to multiply. So, I'm going to multiply this 4 times everything up here. So that's going to give me 3 to the 12 minus 4x. Be very careful with that. You want to distribute it to everything. And over here, negative 1 times 5x is going to be negative 5x. And then negative 1 times a negative 6 is going to be positive 6. Now here's where we find that we have matching bases. If this is truly an equation, it is equal. It is in balance. If these bases are the same, then there is no other option than the fact that these exponents have to be equivalent if this truly is an equation, if it's truly balanced. So what I usually like to do is kind of come off to the side and say, well, if that's true, then 12 minus 4x has to equal negative 5x plus 6. Right? Okay. And then we do a little bit of algebra. Add the 5x over here and we get x. Subtract the 12. 6 minus 12, that's going to give me a negative 6. Now, I do want to check my answer. 81 to the 3 minus a negative 6. 81 to the 9th. Does that equal 1/3 to the 5 times negative 6 plus 6? Now, let me ask you something here. Am I going to get an extraneous solution? Are exponents, do they have limitations? No. They're always going to be okay. That's negative 30 plus 6 is negative 24. And here I would be okay with using your calculator and double checking that 81 to the 9th power is the same as 1/3 to the negative 24th. So let's see. 81 to the, what did I get? That can't be 9. Hold on. Yeah, it is. 81 to the 9th power. Whoops. Oh, I hit the exponent button twice. Gives me that. Now I've got 1/3 to the negative 24. Oh, I did it in the wrong one. That was, the original was 5x minus 6. No wonder. That should be negative 36. No wonder that wasn't coming out right. So just to give you a heads up, that sometimes teachers make mistakes too. So there we go. They're equivalent. But just for future reference, will the exponents ever give you a bad answer? No. The times you're really going to need to check that are when you have logarithms, or when you're taking square roots, or when you're dividing by something. So, okay, let's go and move on to the next one. Now we have two logarithms, one on each side. We want to, again, figure out a way where we have, like here, we had a base with an exponent, a base with an exponent, and the bases were the same. Here, I'd like to get it where it's just log equals log. Well, I don't want that 2 in front. Do we know any techniques to move that 2 somewhere? We sure do. That really can be rewritten as x squared. So again, matching bases, that really means that x squared has to equal 9. Well, if I come off to the side and look at x squared equals 9, when it's plus or minus 3. Now here's where we need to think about our answers. When we check 3 going in there, we're fine. Negative 3, can my argument be negative? No. So it's just x equals 3. We have an extraneous solution at negative 3. All right, the next type of problems you might run across. All right, on this one, we're going to try to rewrite in opposite form. In other words, we started with the logarithms. We're going to rewrite it as an exponential. Now, these two logarithms are being added. It'd be nicer if they were combined into one. So when we add logarithms, we combine them with multiplication. So when I rewrite it that, I'm going to have x plus 3 times 2 minus x. When we FOIL that out, we'll end up with negative x squared minus x plus 6. Now, here's where I'm going to try to rewrite this logarithm. So, the base of the logarithm becomes the base of the exponential. The answer to a logarithm is always my exponent. Now, 4 to the 1 is just 4. And I have a quadratic equation. So I'd like to get everything on one side set equal to 0. So when I bring that over, that becomes x squared plus x. Subtract the 6, so I get negative 2 equals 0. Be really nice if this would just factor. Well, that's going to be x and x. Multiply to be negative 2 and add to be 1. That's got to be 2 and negative 1. So my two possible answers are x equals negative 2 and x equals 1. So I need to double check. If I plug these back in, negative 2 plus 3, I'm okay. 2 minus a negative 2, I'm okay. What about plugging in the 1? 1 plus 3, I'm good. 2 minus 1, I'm good. These are actually both good answers. Alright, for the next example, I have an exponential inside of there. So the first thing I want to do is isolate this. Get it all by itself. So let's start by subtracting 1 from both sides. And I'll get 12. Now we want to get rid of the 3 in front, so divide both sides by 3. Now, there are actually two ways to finish this problem out. So let's talk through those two ways. Method one. Well, it is to rewrite it, like we said up there. What if we rewrite that? That would be x equals the logarithm base 4.5 of 4. That is an exact solution. Now, if I was going to find my approximate solution, I could use the change of base formula, which says I'm going to take the log of 4 divided by the log of 4.5. And I would put that in my calculator and get the approximation. And let's go 3 decimal places here. So log of 4 divided by log of 4.5. I get 922, sorry. All right, now there is another way to solve this. So let's look at method two. Now method two, we still have, here's our equation, okay. Remember the rules of algebra. What thou doest to one side, thou doest to the other, and you keep things balanced, right? Well, what if I took the log of both sides? Let's see what happens. So I'd have log, and then over here would be log of 4. Okay? Now, exponent rule. That exponent can be moved to the front, right? So I get x times log of 4.5 equals log of 4. Now, to get x all by itself, log of 4.5 is just some number. So x times a number, well, I can just divide by that number. So I'm going to divide both sides by log of 4.5. And I get that x equals log of 4 over log of 4.5. Guess what? It doesn't matter which way I do it. I came out with the same thing. So I'm fine with you doing that one either way. All right. Now, I've got one more example, and it's a doozy. But I really want you to see how this would happen. All right. Let's say we have a problem that is totally different. In this problem, my bases are not alike. I can't even make them be alike. There's no way. I just can't do it. Remember that technique we just used back there? What if I took the log of both sides? Now just bear with me. I can do this. I know how. And I would say don't try this at home, but I do want you to try this at home. I'll get log of 5 to the x minus 2 equals log of 3 to the 3x plus 2. Okay. So now, I have logarithms. Exponent rule. Exponents can be rewritten in the front. Now, I'm talking about that whole exponent. So we're talking about all of the x minus 2. And so here again, all of 3x plus 2. Now, here's where people might have a problem. Whoops. Oh well, that's okay. I really wanted to do it around 3. Log of 3 is just a number. Log of 5 is just a number. I mean, I could put it in the calculator and get the decimal. So don't be scared of it. It's just a number. What I'm going to do is distribute that number to each of the things in the parentheses. So I would have x times log of 5 minus 2 times log of 5. What about over here? Same thing. Log of 3 is going to get distributed to both of these. So I'd have 3x times log of 3 plus 2 times log of 3. Now, we've gotten it all expanded out. There's no more exponents. There's no more parentheses. What I'd like to do is get all the x's on one side. So let's see. We've got an x here. And there's an x here. I want both of those on the same side. So let's choose that side. That's a better side. So, x log 5 is going to stay there. When I move this one over, I've got to subtract it. So it becomes minus 3x log 3. Now, on the right side, I already had 2 log 3. This doesn't have an x in it, so it's going to go to this other side. We're subtracting here, so to get rid of it, I need to add it. So that would be adding 2 log 5. Now, this is the step that will blow your mind. So be paying attention. I want everybody to be paying attention. Put down your cell phones. Pay attention. X and X. It's showing up there like it was distributed into both of those terms. I am going to undistribute it, aka factor. I'm going to factor out an x. That leaves me with log 5 minus, and here would be 3 log 3 left. Over on this side, I will have 2 log 3 plus 2 log 5. Now, remember, log 5, log 3, all that stuff, that's just, those are decimals. We're just not wanting to write down all those ugly decimals right now. That's all they are, though. Now, next step, to get rid of this decimal thingy, ugly decimal thingy, just divide it out. Same thing over here. Now, if I was going to put this in the calculator, I would actually put them both in parentheses. And lo and behold, I got to wait until the very end to put it in the calculator. Now, why would I wait to the very, very end to put it in the calculator? Well, that's because I want to keep it as exact as possible until the very end. If you round somewhere in the middle of your problem, you're more likely to have made a mathematical mistake by rounding. If we wait until the very, very end, then we are good to go. That's negative 3.212. Done! And that's it.